As you see in this webinar, I would like to explore and report you on the recent advance in a new and very interesting approach to study fish status and welfare, the skin mucus. In this sense, I have proposed this title for my presentation, The Skin Mucus, the New Frontier in Fish Innate Immune Response. Okay, move on with the main aim of the webinar, to focus on mucus and the immune system and defenses. Traditionally, the immune system is divided into the innate or non-specific immune system, also called a genetic immune system, and the adaptive or a specific immune system, also called acquired immune system. The fish immune system, like the other vertebrates, has both types of immunity. The innate or non-specific immunity is the first line of defense to deal with the different pathogens. This defensive system can be divided into three main components: the mucosal immunity, the humoral immunity, and the tissue or cellular immune system. There are three main mucosal systems in the fish body: the skin mucosa, the gill mucosa, and the mucosa of the digestive tract. In this slide, I would like to show you an schematic, only a schematic view of the fish immune system. As I said, the fish immune system is divided into the innate and the adaptive immune systems, both divided into cell-mediated defense and humoral factors. And it is known that these two systems work together in order to destroy the invaders or to trigger defense processes. The innate immune system includes the components of the physical barriers, such as the skin and the other mucosas, the cell-mediated defense, formed by the granulocytes, monocytes, macrophages, and other natural killer cells. The humoral defense here, is formed by a large number of elements, such as the complement system, the antimicrobial PEP enzymes, the interleukins, etc., etc. And also the inflammation is considered an innate immune mechanism, mediate the complex interaction of cellular and humoral compounds. The specific system or the adaptive immunity system requires the presence of an antigen, and this antigen is a strange molecule or cell that will initiate a set of internal reactions here, I don't want to detail them, which could mean in the increase in the circulation of the specific antibodies. Moreover, in a second moment, this immune system will promote the immune memory. These antibodies recognize and join to those antigens and subsequently activate the phagocytosis, and this indicates that the both immune systems act together. I repeat, I have shown you and explained or tried to explain you a very reduced version of the immune system, and sure, as you know, the immune system is more complex. If we want to focus in the mucosal system, we recognize these mucosas: the skin mucosa, the gill mucosa, the digestive mucosa, and even the nasal pharyngeal mucosa. They are in intimate contact with the aqueous environment, which can be constantly changing, and with a number of potential pathogens. To maintain whole body homeostasis, these mucosal barriers are armed with the so-called mucosal associated lymphoid tissues with both innate and adaptive components. For each mucosa, it was defined one kind of mucosal associated lymphoid tissues, the gut associated, the skin associated, the gill associated, and nasopharyngeal associated. Focusing in the skin mucosa, this slide represents the immunocomponents which are described or present in this mucosa. Obviously, there are physical barriers like formed by the own mucus layer, the epithelial, from the epithelial cells, and from the scales. So I repeat, this is the four main components: the physical barriers from the skin mucosa, the cell-mediated defense are marked in blue, the humoral defense here are reduced to the AMPs, but there are a lot of proteins related with this humoral defense. And the acquired defense are only in the skin, but not in the mucus. Okay, it is good that if in fish an initial response in one mucosal will generate similar response in the other mucosal tissues. This would mean that after a stress condition, the specific mucosa affected by several produce here several mediators that that will act on the rest of mucosas, activating similar response. If this hypothesis is right, we usually perform some experiments to improve the fish status. For instance, some diets could include immunostimulant products, prebiotics, probiotics, specific additives like amino acids, high concentrated fatty acids, with the aim to fortify the fish defense. And typically, this has been measured at digestive tract level. If the previous hypothesis is right, when we stimulate one mucosa, the rest of the mucosal system of the body should be also stimulated. Thus, we propose to study the benefits or the effects of the affectations on fish, analyzing skin mucus as a non-invasive way. So, focusing the skin mucosa. Briefly, the skin mucosa is structured in different layers. That includes the hypodermis, the dermis, and the epidermis. The epidermis is made of several cell types, including the famous mucus cells, Golgi cells, Klebs cells. Also, there are sensory cells. Obviously, the skin-associated lymphoid tissue cells, the pigmentary cells, and other cells. And the epidermis is responsible for the formation of the mucus. This mucus is a viscous fluid with a gradual resistance to deformation and in contact with the surrounding water, obviously. And recently, we distinguish between soluble and insoluble mucus fractions, which have different composition, different functions, and different exudation mechanisms. The skin mucus participate in a lot of physiological functions, act as a physical barrier, present and secrete to the mucus the components of the innate defense, also participate in communication, is a fate of some excreted products, and also participates in the respiration. As I said, this classical diagnosis are invasive. Obviously, tissue samples obtention is absolutely invasive and implies the animal sacrifice. The blood analysis may become a rapid and non-lethal tool. However, blood extraction could add an extra stress for the fish. So we propose the collection of this more external layer of skin mucosa, the mucus, which could be considered as a non-invasive or minimally invasive way to study.